Hi, I'm Jared, software engineer for Glass. I'm going to talk to you about localizing Mirror API Glassware. What is Mirror API Glassware? Mirror API Glassware uses the Mirror API to push static content to Glass through a RESTful API. The cards appear on Glass in the timeline, but the way content is pushed is different than a traditional website. For a traditional website, when a request comes in, it's easy to determine what language to use to show your content. You might use the accept language header, geolocate the request IP, have a user setting, or any combination of the above, and then return localized content. But with the Mirror API, you don't have incoming request headers or even an incoming request. You're pushing content to the API, and you want that content to be in the same language as the rest of Glass for that user. So Mirror API now supports HTTP GET for user settings, and the first setting is called locale. To get the user locale, you make a request to the Mirror API. Here's how it works. You request the setting locale, and the API returns a locale string to you, such as EL. You can then produce and push your timeline item using whatever templating technology you like, using that locale string to select the appropriate translation. There are lots of internationalization pitfalls that you should be aware of. For instance, hard-coded strings, truncated text, time formatting, etc. These issues are basically the same whether you're writing web apps, Android apps, or GDK Glassware. But the mechanisms for solving them are different. Localizing Mirror API timeline items is very similar to localizing web applications. In fact, you can probably use the same facilities you're already using for your web apps. Maybe you use Rails, Angular, Django, or Clojure templates. These frameworks all have mechanisms for localizing your content. Use those mechanisms the same way you would for traditional web content. It's really straightforward. Once you're pushing localized content, you probably don't want to perform a GET to settings locale for every timeline item. That would double how many requests you make against Mirror API and burn your quota with unnecessary requests. Instead, what you can do is subscribe to changes in the settings collection, similar to the way you subscribe to timeline or location updates. Now, whenever someone changes their language for Glass, you'll get a notification callback which tells you it's time to get the locale setting again and store the new value for that user. So you want to subscribe to settings changes, and when you get a change notification, you retrieve the locale for that user. And whenever you want to push content, you just use the locale string that you've already retrieved and remembered. And depending on your app, you may want to refresh existing timeline items to reflect the new language. After you've localized either your Mirror API Glassware or GDK Glassware, submit it to the Glass team for review. You should specify all the languages that your Glassware supports so we can show it to users who speak that language. You can see how easy it is to localize your Mirror API Glassware and reach more users. Watch for announcements from Glass team for upcoming language support in Glass. Thanks.